Namaste everyone, my name is Shiv. I'm a yoga and a wellness coach. So this pandemic has given us a hard time. So we want a good shield immunity to fight against it. So yoga is one of the ancient science, an ancient fitness discipline which is going to help us to shield our immunity, make our body more stronger, reduce our stress and have a strong toned body. So now we are going to do some breathing practices, some yoga poses, a meditation which can really help us to elevate some chronic diseases, some chronic stress, and at the same time build a good, strong immunity. Let's get started. Please get on your mats. So the first practice and a first pose is Tadasana. Tadasana means tree pose, okay? So we will take 1 foot distance in the legs. That means shoulder width apart, okay? Foot should be parallel to each other. Both the hands are going to be on the sides, shoulders retracted, chin parallel to the ground, chest slightly opened up, separated from each other. We'll look straight, we'll take 3 deep breaths before we start. Give yourself that parasympathetic shift. There you go. Now look straight, keep your eyes open, take a deep breath. Now raise your arms up and simultaneously come up on your toes. Extend yourself as much as you can. As much as you can. Stretch the entire body. Feel that extension. Hold it. 9, 8, make sure you're not losing your concentration. 7, 6, breathe fully. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. Now squeezing the back very gently, bringing your heels down with your hands on the sides. Fantastic. So that's Tadasana. So the extension of Tadasana is really going to help you expand your body, stretch your shoulders, stretch your all the limbs so that you can get a good flexible start to your yoga practice. Okay. We'll increase the distance of the legs a little more, just a little more, okay? So this is legs slightly apart from the shoulder. Pull the legs out, right hand is going to be on the waist, left arm goes up over the head. Again, as you're taking your arms up, make sure you're breathing in deeply. Slowly give yourself a little exhalation, keeping the hips aligned with the body. Slowly bend yourself laterally on the right. Extend your left arm as much as you can. Now this lateral flexion is very important. Stay there for 6 seconds at least. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Notice what is happening in the body right now. Wow. Fantastic. Come back right in the middle. Squeezing the back. Bring your hands down. Now the lateral flexion is very, very important if you want to increase and, you know, open up all the breathing channels in the body. So there are different nadis, different nerves which are working to every part of the body. They are networks, okay? So to open them up, we have to do lateral flexion. Left arm goes on the waist, right arm goes up over the head, extending the entire body. Once again, breathe fuller in, exhale, and very gently bend to the left side. Once again, as I said, the extension is very important. Once again, 6 counts, here we go. When I say 6 counts, you have to take 6 breaths, slow and deep, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come back right in the middle. Squeezing the back, bring your hands down again. So these are some of the practices which are going to help us to open up our chest and remove all the congestion. Okay, in Ayurveda we call it Kapha. So Kapha Dosha is, this is one of the respiratory disorders, especially the pandemic, this corona itself. So this is going to really help us to open up the chest and remove those congestion points, okay? Now, from here, Moving on to the other asana, make sure the leg distance is same as konasana. This is called as kati chakrasana. Kati means your spine itself. Now always remember, your spine is just an extension of the brain. Okay, how well your brain works, that well your spine will work as well, and vice versa. So spine needs to stay straight, will look straight. Again, body needs to stay stable. Make sure your hip, your pelvis is completely straight at one point. Both the hands at the shoulder level up. Now very gently inhale deep. Exhale, twist your body to the left. Now as you're twisting, feel that diagonal twist. Now my left arm goes behind the back. Okay, I block it behind. My right arm goes on the left shoulder, or wherever I can keep it. And I will look behind. Just stay in this position. Make sure you are not taking your hips like this or even like this, okay? Somewhere nearly in the middle. Keep looking behind. Again, as I said, 6 breaths. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. Come back. Inhale, right in the middle. Exhale again, simultaneously twist yourself to the right. As I said, hip alignment is necessary. Do not take it like this or do not take it like this. Somewhere in the middle. Right arm goes right behind the back and left arm goes on the right shoulder. Again, 6 breaths. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Super stuff. Inhale and exhale. So you see, I'm doing inhalations and exhalations together. Why? Because the syncing of the breath to the movement is very, very important, especially for neuromuscular coordination. Okay, once again, now we'll decrease the distance of the legs. So we'll bring both the legs together so that both the feet is kissing each other. This is my posture. Now from here, very gently, I will take my buttocks a little behind, bending the knees, and I will bend forward. Keep looking straight. I'll bend forward. Forward, 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 forward. And I will put my hands down if I can. So if you cannot put your hands down, you can simply keep it on the ankles, okay? Right in the front. Or you can just keep it a little behind. The idea is to feel the posture, not to go into it completely, okay? If you can't stretch, it's okay. Just maintain wherever you are. Yoga is a progressive practice. As you do it, slowly, slowly, you increase your flexibility. Shift the body weight on the toes, okay? Keep your hands on the sides and bring the crown of the head. The crown of the head parallel to the ground itself. Fantastic. Stay there again, as I said. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very gently, taking the help of your thighs, bending the knees, slowly come up. So this is called as Pada Hastasana. Pada means my legs, Hasta means my hands, touching my legs, or as I can keep it on the sides. Now this is a fantastic asana, especially for people who have inflammation, okay, people who have joints problem. Now because of pandemic, because of less immunity, you might have joint pain, knee problem, and all these things. So when you bend forward, you're taking care of your hip joint, from the energy point from which your entire bone is made stronger. Okay, now from this asana, slowly we'll maintain the position. Once again, I'll face this side so that you can see me. I'll hook my both hands behind the waist, okay, keeping my body straight. I will take a deep breath. And I will give myself a nice arch. Just arch yourself a little, okay? Look up all the way to the ceiling. Maintain the posture. Fantastic. Again, as I told you, the expansion of the chest is important. So this is again the asana which is going to help you boost your immunity. Stay there. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic.
come back in the middle. So when you bend it forward, it was Pada Hastasana. So when I came up, when I arched behind, it became Ardha Chakrasana, or I may also call it Uttan Asana. Uttan means extension and I am arching behind. Okay, from here, I will move on to another asana. Now the asana which is very important, and that is called as a Trikona Asana, the triangle pose. Why it is asana? As I said, the important asana, because when we are laterally bending, the lateral bending asanas are really helpful to increase or remove the blocked breathing channels. Okay, so now I will face this side. One foot, the other foot, and the other foot. So I will keep my leg here. My right leg is perpendicular, if you can see. Okay, make sure the heel should be in one line. Both the heels should be in one line. Okay, this is my position. My both the hands will go out. Okay, do not stress yourself too much, but make sure you are bending in this manner, not in this manner. So there is a huge difference. When you bend in this manner, you are not going to tap that particular area where we have to press. Okay, so make sure you are bending this way. So this is my position. Keep the right knee soft. Do not keep it contracted like this. Keep it a little soft, okay? Hip should be in alignment. Slowly, slowly shift the hips a little back. This is my position. Slowly I will bend myself and I will hold my right ankle, or maybe a little above the right ankle. After holding, I will look at my left arm, middle finger. Make sure you open up your left side of the chest a little more, so that there you can see the left arm middle finger. Just make sure you are pointing at that particular point. And again, as I said, 6 breaths. 6, 5, 4, 3. Now if you could take your hands more down, perfect. You can go ahead. Now if you could put your hands down on the floor, very good. Now if you can touch your toes, fantastic. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly bending the knees. Make sure the pressure should not be on the lower back, because when you come up, the pressure will be on the lower back. So make sure you bend the knees and protecting your back, you come back up. Or you might feel the little cracking sensation behind, okay, near the psoas. So be careful when you are coming up. Right leg comes inside, left leg will go out. Okay. Now once again, we will repeat the same on the left side as well. My arms go out. I start pointing position. I will look straight. Take a deep breath. After exhaling simultaneously, I will bend again. Somehow, keeping the knee soft, I will look at the right arm and the finger again. So you see, I'm holding my leg. I will look at the left arm, right arm and middle finger. I will stay here. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. Now I can go more deeper if you want to. As I said, if you want, you can even touch your toes. But don't be harsh with yourself. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. Now while coming back, you have to be very careful, especially if you are a blood pressure or a diabetes patient, and also if you are a cardiac patient. So when you're coming back, there is a jerk on the heart, there is a jerk on the breathing part, and there's also a jerk on the lower back. So make sure you be careful when you are coming up. Now we'll move on to the other practice. Now I'll keep my both the legs down. Should be somewhere in the middle. Okay. Once again, I will hook my hands right behind. I will take a deep breath and I will give myself a nice arch. So the moment you come down in this posture, you see the bend goes a little more deeper. You can bend a little more deeper than the Uttanasana itself. Once again, a beautiful asana, especially if you want a good strong chest, a good strong lower back. 3, 2,
One, fantastic. Come back and take a little. So if you have digestion problem, if you have constipation problem, this asana is also going to help you for that. Moving on. So, we did Trikonasana, then we did Ustrasana, which was backward arch, the camel pose. And now we will move on to one of the most famous asana. Okay, you have seen this in Bollywood, Hollywood, everywhere. Okay, some of the stars practicing it. Now you're going to lie down on the abdomen. Okay, slowly. Now, as I said, lying down on the abdomen is very necessary. So how you're going to lie down, that is very, very important. So I'm lying down like this because I'm young and a little strong. Okay, so generally if you are a patient or you are going through any convalescence recovery period, keep your elbows down, turn to one side, okay? And then very gently turn yourself on the abdomen and lie down. So the anterior side is facing on the floor. My hands will go on the sides. Now, the important thing here is your thumb should be somewhere near your nipples, okay? My elbow will hug from behind. I will bring my both legs together. Now, the important part is if you will keep your legs together, the pressure will be on the lower back. The moment you take it out, the pressure will be more on the upper thoracic region. So you have to be careful that you keep your lower back together. So Sarala Bhujangasana, the traditional classical Bhujangasana, is performed in this manner. Okay, so my both hands are on the sides, elbows hugging the body, toes pointed, forehead on the floor. I will breathe normally, prepare myself, especially I will prepare my mind. Take a deep breath and give yourself a nice arch. Now do not put too much pressure on the arms, okay? If you are a carpal, if you have carpal problem, please do not put pressure on the arms, okay? Just arch your back. But if you can go a little more further, press your palms a little more and come somewhere here. Okay, so this is the perfect position. Make sure you are not looking up, you are looking straight. You will feel that little sweet pain sensation in the lower back. 6, 5, 4 and come down. Make sure you don't hold it for too long, because if you will hold it for too long, this is going to put pressure on the arms and you might feel the pain in the shoulders as well. So weight evenly distributed, my hands again on the side. I will take a deep breath for 3 counts. Inhale up. I'm here. I will stay here for 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. And slowly down. I'll do it again because this is one of the most important asana. And I think you should do it too with me. Okay? One more set. 3 times, 3rd time. Inhale. And once again an arch. Keep looking straight. 6, 5, 4, be very still like a cobra. 3, enter. Relax. So you can remove your hands, keep it on the sides, and just stay in this position to relax yourself. Fantastic. Breathe in, breathe out. As I said, every time you are relaxing, focus on the breath. The more you stay with the breath, the lesser you are going to feel the pain of all the stretches. Now, moving ahead. Now, slowly my hands will stay outside. I'll bring my legs together. So there's something called as Chaturanga. As I said, all stretches are very good, but we also want strength in our body, okay? So no matter how much flexible you are, but if you don't have strength, you might not be able to resist some strong sensations coming from outside, okay? Which are going to touch the physical body. So you need a strong body to face anything, to lift anything, and to be healthy for a longer period of time. And that's why you see we have this great culture of gymming. Why? Because after gymming, our muscles break down, we look more good, we look more sculpted, and we look aesthetic. So aesthetically, people want to grow, so they go to the gym. Okay, but as I said, yoga also got cure for this. So I'll keep my hands right in the front, okay? I will make sure
my hands are not on the shoulders like this. My hands are right in front of the chest. Very important. I will take one leg back and I will bring another leg back this way. I will stay here for 6 seconds, looking straight. Six, make sure the body is parallel. It should not be up here or it should not be down. Make sure it is somewhere in the middle. Do not hold it for too long if you have any cardiac problem. If you have any problem that is connected to carpal bone, or if you have any problem where you are feeling a lot of lower back pain. Okay, so be careful, do it for 6 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, progressively you can increase it. Down, and I'm looking straight. Six, breathe full and deep. Five, four, three, two, one. Fantastic. Keep the knees down. Come back. So you saw there was a lot of pressure on my arms, but at the same time my entire body was engaged. So my hands were just not becoming strong. With my hands, my hips also was becoming strong. My legs also were becoming strong. And my abdomen was getting toned. Okay? Moving ahead. Yeah. So after Chaturanga, again, as I said, one of the most important yogic asana, which is going to help you clean your bowel. Okay, we'll go back. I'll sit down. My both hands will go a little behind. Keep your legs straight right in front of you. Fold the right leg in. Now you don't have to be too harsh with yourself. You can keep your foot here, or you can keep it here as well. My heel should be near my testicles, okay? My genital. I will drop my knees down. Now this is one of the best asanas, especially for women who are going through up and down menses cycle, women who are going through PCOD, and men who are going through endocrine dysfunction, or if they are also going through erectile dysfunction. So you see, I'm going upright completely. My foot is facing towards me, okay? This is very important. Like a mirror, my foot is facing towards me. I am, as my trunk is in the interior position, I'm facing towards my left leg. I have no connection with the right leg whatsoever. I will raise my arms up. I will exhale now, take the abdomen inside. Lengthening the spine, not just stretch from the hands, lengthening the lower spine. So you are not doing this, you are doing this. So this is important. Go forward. This way, forward, 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 forward. And I could grab my foot, thank God. But if you can't do it, no problem, you can just keep your legs here as well. But make sure your knees are contracted, okay? Because as we are doing the asana, we have to feel the pressure on the abdomen. Okay, holding the foot. Go a little further if you can. Now again, if you can't go further, no problem, just stay wherever you are. It's all about experiencing the asana. As you practice it, you will increase your flexibility. Now I could drop my head down. If you can drop your head down, enjoy. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Raise the arms up. And I will bring my hands down. Fantastic. So if you have lower back pain, don't push yourself too much. Just do it according to your capacity. We'll do the same on the other side. My right leg goes straight, left leg comes in. My heel will be near the genital. I will drop it downwards. My foot is facing towards me, especially the right foot. I will raise my arms up, inhale. I will take my abdomen in, lengthening my spine, holding the foot firmly. Again, I can drop my forehead even on the right leg. Okay, so I'll go further. If you can do it, do it. If you can't, no problem. You're still a great yogi. Okay, six, five, five, four, three, two, one. Raise the arms up. Breathe the hands down. I'm already feeling good because the pressure was a lot on the abdomen. And if you know the energy center, which is here, is called as solar plexus.
So when you press it, a lot of physical problems are going to be cured. A lot of physical diseases are going to be get alleviated. Okay, moving ahead. Yeah, Janu is good. Setu Bandhasana. Setu Bandhasana. Yeah. Sir? Now, from Dhanushasana, okay, head to toe pose. From here, slowly we will lie down. As I said, if you are a cardiac patient or a pregnant lady, or if you are also a blood pressure patient, always remember how you get up and how you sleep, because that affects your heart rate. Okay, that also affects your in blood pressure, your diastolic and systolic pressure. So I will turn my body to one side. From here, I will gently lie down on my back. So this is the perfect way. So earlier we were lying down on the Bhujangasana. So our anterior was facing on the ground. Now my posterior is facing on the ground. Okay, I'll adjust my t-shirt. My foot should be parallel to each other. That means my legs. Okay, there should be enough distance, at least shoulder width apart, okay, or hip distance apart. My hands will go on the side. Do not pressurize yourself too much. But when you're coming up, always remember you are going to apply the pressure from the sole of the foot. Okay, so you have to press the sole of the foot on the floor. Take a deep breath, inhale, and lift the hips up. Lift the hips up as much as you can. Now lift yourself so much, only if you can, ki your chin should touch the upper chest. Bring yourself up. See, I'm bringing myself till my chin touches the upper chest. So if you can come here, fantastic. If you can't take it, you can just stay here somewhere, okay? Just relax yourself. Slowly, by as you do practice progressively, you will increase your hip flexing capacity, okay? Then you will come up slowly and you will stay here. As I said, 6 breaths. 6, 5, 4. If you feel the pain in the foot, bring yourself down. No harsh movements. So you see my lower back is flat here. So this itself is a posture which is going to help you elevate your lower back pain. Okay? Just stay in this position. If you are an ankylosing patient, if you are a spondylitis patient, if you are an arthritis patient, this is a fantastic asana for you. Okay? And also as you are coming up, you are expanding your chest. So, thymus, immunity, and reducing the corona damage. Put the hands on sides. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Once again coming up. 3 breaths. 3. Notice my abdominal movement. 2. 1. And come down. Fantastic. As we are here, we'll do one more set because this is a fantastic asana. Okay? And the more you do it, the better you are going to feel. Inhale. Coming up again. The last time we are doing this. Come on, enjoy it completely. Have a good time. 3. 2, 1, and my hip goes down again. Super stuff. So far, so good. I hope you're doing it with me. Now, my both the legs.
Pawn.
Fantastic. Pawn is the last of the legs.
No, Shavasana.
Shavasana. Okay. Yeah. Ali? Shavasana. Okay. Now, from Setu Bandhasana, we also have to reciprocate every asana. Remember, if you are doing the backward bend, okay? Now we'll move on to forward bend. So always remember, ki after any backward bend, you also have to do forward bend to realign your spine, okay? So now, I'm lying down. The asana that we are going to perform right now is also called as the Pavan Muktasana. Pavan means air. Mukta means liberated. So there are different forms of air according to yogic scriptures. So there is Apan Vayu, Udan Vayu, Saman Vayu. So all the airs are doing different work. But there are also stale air. There is also air which is going to disturb the harmony of the body. So to make it more harmonious, our body more harmonious, we are going to do Pavan Muktasana. Bring your both the legs towards your chest. Okay. My hands will be on the shin bone.
I will press it little firmly. If you can't do it, no problem. Just hold the posture. Now here again, one of the posture, it can help you to remove your lower back pain. Now take a deep breath. Now this is where you are going to release the stale air from the body. Exhale, bring the head up and bring your nostrils as close as possible towards your knees. Now if you could touch it, stay there and breathe normally. 6, 5, 4, stay there, 3. Now if you have any cervical issues, keep your head down, okay? You might feel the pain in the cervical. So you can just bring your legs as much as possible in front of the chest and squeeze it. See, I'm trying to squeeze. And now you are completely prepared with a good yoga poses, and you have also boosted your immunity through the asanas. And now to reset the nervous system, nervous impulses, and to reduce the stress in the body, physical, mental, or emotional, whatever, we'll open up our palms, we'll open up the legs, we'll relax our body completely. Looking at the ceiling, very gently close your eyes. And now let the sound be empty like an echo. Look at experience beyond your thoughts. Do not keep any stiff area in your body. Do not keep any stiff area in your body. And just remind yourself one thing, that nothing is more important than your inner peace. Just lie down and relax yourself. Now remember everyone, the more you become still, according to yogic scriptures, when you become still, you reveal some deeper wisdoms within your body. You understand your body better, you understand your thoughts better, and you become a better, more harmonious human being. This is where you are uniting your body, mind, and spirit. This is where you're coming in terms with your nature, with the nature. Just feel the physical structure. Again, as I said, let your thoughts come and go. Do not fall for them. The more you relax, the more you reset your nervous system, the better your nervous system can tackle the immunity system issues. Be as still as possible. Turn yourself to right side, you can turn yourself to left side. Take the help of one arm and slowly sit back in normal cross-leg position. So now, as I said, this thought process, the mind itself every day runs with somewhere around 60,000 thoughts, 60,000 plus thoughts, okay? So to tackle them is very important. Your thoughts may ruin your life, may give you some more diseases, can down-regulate your genes and give you innumerous disorders, okay? So, can you stop your thoughts? No, you can't stop your thoughts. The only thing that you can do is you can regulate your thoughts with syncing it with the breath itself, okay? Some of the practices that we are going to do is going to boost our immunity, give us less stress, which is very, very important, especially in this corona period, pandemic period. My hands are going to be on the thighs, spine should be wrapped, shoulders retracted, I will look straight. We will start our practice with the Dirgha Pranayama. Pranayama, in short terms, in layman's language, means restraining, controlling the breath. And yogis say, yogic scriptures say, the ancient doctors say, ki when you
tackle your breath, when you control your breath, automatically you will have indirect control over your mind. And that's the beautiful part of pranayama. Both the hands on the thighs. My right arm goes on the chest, my left arm goes on the abdomen. Okay. We take some deep breaths, at least 6 rounds, 6 breaths. Okay. Inhale, expand your abdomen. Open up your rib cages. Open up the shoulders. And exhale, bring your shoulder down, chest down, and the abdomen down. Inhale. Bring a gentle smile on your face. Exhale. Bring your hands down. So notice how beautifully you have increased your oxygen saturation rate. The more the oxygenation, you remember, the better the cell will get the food. And there are different and many millions of cells inside your body. The more they are better, the better will be your entire physical structure. Okay, moving ahead to another pranayama.
I'm breathing, fire breathing, abdominal breathing.
Fire breathing. And now, so my left palm goes out. I will keep it in Dhyana Mudra, okay, which is also called as a knowledge gesture. Okay, so mudra means gesture, a sign, a symbol. Okay, so if I tell you hi, this means hi, this means Dhyana. Okay, so this is the mudra, joining the tip of the thumb with the index finger. I'll keep it on my thigh. I will keep my right palm on the abdomen. Okay, now I have to do, why it is called as fire breathing? Because you are pushing the abdominal agni. Agni means, which is also called as in Ayurveda, this is called as Jatra Agni. Jatra Agni means the heat that is there inside the body, which helps us to digest our food. So to digest our food better, to make our gut more healthier, this is very important, especially if you want, again, a good immunity system, a good breathing capacity, as well as a good tidal volume breathing. Right palm goes on the abdomen. I will take a deep breath. I will exhale completely so that there is some stale air, it will go out. And we are doing forceful, remember, not forced, forceful. It looks forceful, okay? Forceful expulsion of the abdomen. So I will exhale, my abdomen will go in with a jerk. You saw, this is first jerk. Second, simple. So when I'm jerking, when I'm exhaling, my exhalation is breath is throwing out, my abdomen is going inside, okay? Close your eyes. Do it very slowly. Take your time. Especially if you are a blood pressure or a cardiac patient, take your time. 2 seconds, 3 seconds, one stroke is enough. We'll do it together for 1 minute. Let's do it. You might feel little pain here and there in the abdomen. It's okay, no problem. It's very normal. The little pressure might come on the lower back. Again, it's okay, not a big deal. Keep going. breathe only. Just keep your hand on the abdomen so that you feel the heat that is being generated with the help of this breathing practice. Gently open your eyes. Moving on to another practice. Now this is alternate nostril breathing. So there are two golardha, what we call as hemispheres of the brain. One is right and the one is left. So there are two nostrils as well. One is Pingla and one is Ida. That means this one is a solar nostril and this one is called as lunar nostril. So when you regulate your right nostril, you get a lot of heating energy. When you regulate your left nostril, you get a lot of soft or cold energy. Okay, but what we need is not the right one and not the left one, but the combination of both. Okay, so to balance the breath, to balance the mind, a state of mind where you can manage everything together. Okay, so after fire breathing, we are coming to alternate nostril breathing. So as I said, our right nostril is known as a solar nostril. Our left nostril is known as lunar nostril. What do we want? We want the heating mode or we want the cold mode? No, we want the combination of both the power. Okay, just like that, we have right hemisphere of the brain and we have left hemisphere of the brain. What do we want? Right one to work more or the left one? You want the combination of both. So now we are going to do alternate nostril breathing, which will help us to bring our mind in a state of harmony, in a state of balance. My left arm will be in Dhyana Mudra. Right arm, ring finger will be on the left nostril. Inhale through the right one. Close the right nostril, simultaneously open the left one. Inhale through the left. Close the left one, exhale through the right. Continue a few breaths. Make sure there is no jerky movement. As you are training, train your mind to stay with the breath. Do not think about anything else. Bring your hands down, gently open your eyes. See, if you will notice, you will automatically, just instantly, you are feeling so good. You're feeling a lot more calmer, a lot more balanced, and a lot more better. Notice if you are breathing this for 10 to 15 times, or you are breathing this for making this practice for 10 to 15 minutes, this can make a world of a difference to you. Moving ahead to the last part of our pranayama, which is one of the most important pranayams, which is also called as bumblebee breathing and also called as Brahmi pranayama. Now, why is the important pranayama? We have heard about vibrations. The vibrations are very important. So we talk about positive vibrations, negative vibrations, but you know that the vibrations are very important in our life. So just like something goes outside, something that is vibrating us outside can affect us. There is also inner vibration, which is very, very important. Okay. So if I give you a little massage through a vibrator or something like that, you will feel much better. So those massage, the machines are vibrating, so they can make you feel much more better. Similarly, inner massage is also important. So this is one of the pranayams, one of the Brahmari practice, which helps us to increase that ultrasonic sound effect inside the body and gives you that nice inner massage. Okay, now my both hands will be in Dhyana Mudra. I will look straight, shoulders retracted. Very gently, I will bring my hands right in front of me. I will keep my index finger on the cartilage of my ears. I will slowly press it very gently. Do not press it too much so that you don't hear my voice. Okay, otherwise you will keep your hands here the whole day. Okay, My hands are here, especially the tip of the finger is on the cartilage, pressing the ear lobes. I will inhale. As you exhale, make a humming sound. Breathe normally. Remember, as you are doing this practice, it is very, very important that you stay with the breath and feel those vibrations, okay? Because the resonance of the sound is what is going to give you that lasting effect. Inhale. Feel the sound. One more time. Bring your hands down on the thighs. Now both the hands will be in Dhyana Mudra. So Brahmhari gives us a beautiful effect where you feel more calm, more relaxed, more centered in your soul. Now both the hands will stay in Dhyana Mudra, the knowledge gesture. And we are on to meditation. Meditation in some classical text means stopping the fluctuations of mind or a prolonged period of concentration. A state of mind where you are completely centered is meditation. Now, as you're staying in this position, make sure you're not thinking about your family, your career, your studies, or anything else. You're just with yourself. Keep a gentle smile on your face. And again, as I said earlier while doing Shavasana, nothing is more important than your inner peace. And I mean it when I say this. Notice as you are meditating, the thoughts may rush in, things may become difficult in your mind, some thoughts might trouble you, but stay there, hang on. Do not give up. Remember, the mind is like an untamed animal, a tiger, which is trying to attack you in the form of thoughts. You don't have to fight with the tiger. You just have to stay like a witness. Witness everything what is happening right now in your mind. But do not attach yourself to anything. Just like we enjoy a movie in a theater, enjoy your thoughts like a movie. Start rubbing your palms. Faster. And keep the lower half of your palms on your eyeballs. Feel the warmth. Take a deep breath. Breathing out, join the hand in Namaskar and gently offer your reverence to the Divine Spirit within all of us. Gratitude to every one of you. Thank you so much, everyone. So here, you learn how to boost your immunity, to get a good strong body, a strong mental health, a harmonious mind, body and spirit. Remember, mind is always over matter. The more you keep your mind healthy through the physical body, through the practices which are ancient, the disciplines which are going to make you more stronger, they are indirectly going to help you make your nervous system, your autonomic nervous system, your immunity system, your endocrine system more stronger. And remember, first there is self, then there are tissues, and then there is organs, and then there are system, and then there is the entire human being. So you were training yourself at a cellular level, okay? So this is very, very important to each and every one of you to apply these practices in your life and make yourself a more better and a healthy human being. Thank you. Namaste.